Welcome to the next lecture of single phase transformer. I hope you have already seen my first lecture in which I have completed principle of working, construction and types, EMF equation, voltage and current ratios and some numericals. Now in this session I am going to complete losses, definition of regulation and efficiency, determination of these by direct loading method and descriptive treatment of auto transformers. Now there are two types of losses occur in the transformer. The losses due to the core, which is known as iron loss, which loss is also known as no load loss or constant loss. The losses which is occur due to the winding, which are copper losses, or it is known as variable loss. This iron losses takes place in the core, hence it is also known as core loss. So there are two types of losses takes place in the core. One is known as hysteresis loss and another is known as eddy current loss. Now what is hysteresis loss? We know that the transformer works on AC supply. So the alternating flux produced in the transformer, when this alternating flux conducting from primary winding to secondary winding through the core, it creates a reversal of magnetization in transformer core. This reversal of magnetization in transformer core creates a loss which is called as hysteresis loss. Hysteresis loss is equal to hysteresis constant into Bm raised to 1.6 F into V. Now in this case, Kh is the hysteresis constant, Bm is the flux density, F is the frequency and V is the volume of the core. Now next loss is eddy current loss. Why this eddy current loss produced? Eddy current, when the flux links with a closed circuit, an EMF is induced in the circuit and current flows. The value of this current depends upon the EMF around the circuit and resistance of the circuit. Since the core is made up of conducting material, this EMF circulate small currents within the body of the material. These circulating currents are known as eddy currents. So these circulating currents are known as eddy currents. Now due to this eddy currents, these currents are not responsible for doing any useful work, but they produces a heat and that loss is known as eddy current loss. So formula for eddy current loss is Ke Bm raised to 2 T square F square, where Ke is the coefficient of eddy current, B is maximum flux density in Weber per meter square, T is the thickness of laminations in meters and F is the frequency in hertz. Now for exam point of view, only the theoretical part of hysteresis and eddy current loss is included. There will be no numericals based on PH and PE formula. Just you have to remember this formula as a theory question. Now there is one question in the question paper that how to reduce these losses. So first consider the hysteresis loss. Now this hysteresis loss is depends upon different parameters like Bm, that is flux density, frequency and volume of the core. But it is also depends upon the type of material we are using for the core. So while choosing the material, now in the PPT there are three types of materials are given: hard steel, wrought iron and silicon steel. So these materials, the BH curve is given to these materials, and the curve under the BH curve, area under the BH curve is smaller, the hysteresis loss is less. So as compared to other two materials, the area under the hysteresis loop for silicon steel is smaller, hence for reducing hysteresis loss, high grade silicon steel is used. Then another question is how to reduce eddy current losses. So here is the example of two cores. This is a solid core and this is the laminated core. So if you see in the solid core, the number of eddy currents are more So the loss, eddy current loss is more. But in laminated structure, what we are doing, we are just placing varnish between the two laminations, so the overall effect of the eddy current gets reduced. So for reducing eddy current, we use laminated structures. Now this is the equivalent circuit diagram of transformer. Now the primary can be shown as a RL circuit, secondary also can be shown as a RL circuit. So R1 is the primary side resistance, X1 is primary side reactance, R2 is secondary side resistance, and X2 is secondary side reactance. So what is Z1? Z1 is the impedance of primary side, and Z2 is impedance of secondary side. Now why I am explaining this equivalent diagram? Because our next loss, that is the copper loss, is depends upon these parameters. Okay, so consider the copper loss. Now why this copper loss? Copper, the winding is made up of copper, and when the current is flowing through the winding, there is a copper loss in the winding due to the current. Now when the current is flowing through the resistance, there is a loss in terms of heat. But when it passing through the reactance, that is it is passing through the inductance, all of you know that inductance never consumes any power. That means the power loss is due to resistance of primary as well as secondary side. So we are considering, for finding the copper loss, resistance R1 as a primary resistance and R2 as a secondary side resistance. Hence the total copper loss is equal to I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. This is the copper loss, and this copper loss is due to the current in the winding. Hence how to reduce this loss? By keeping resistance as small as possible. Now there is another method for finding the copper loss. Now in case of transformer, mathematically we can transfer any side resistance, that means primary side resistance on the secondary side or secondary side resistance on the primary side, without affecting the performance of the transformer. So here I am transferring secondary side resistance on the primary side. So in that case, R1E is equivalent resistance referred to primary side. So R1E is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. Now what is R2 dash? R2 dash is secondary resistance of transformer referred to primary side. And how to calculate the value of R2 dash? R2 dash is equal to R2 upon K square. Now what is K? K is nothing but the transformation ratio. All of you know that formula. K is equal to E2 by E1 is equal to V1 by V2, which is equal to N2 by N1, which is equal to I1 by I2. And then the copper loss is equal to I1 square into R1E, where what is I1? I1 is the primary side current, and R1E is the equivalent resistance referred to primary side. In sometimes in the numericals, the value of R1E is given, so that time we have to use the formula as I1 square into R1E. Now the method number 3. In this particular method, I am transferring primary side resistance on the secondary side. Okay, so here R2E is equivalent resistance referred to secondary side. So R2E is equal to R1 dash plus R2. Now what is R1 dash? R1 dash is primary resistance of transformer referred to secondary. So R1 dash is equal to K square into R1. Again, K is the transformation ratio. So copper loss is equal to I2 square into R2E. So I2 is what? Secondary side current. And R2 is equivalent resistance referred to secondary side. So if we calculate copper loss by using any formula, any of the three formula. Now this is the relation between voltage, current and resistance. So in the transformer, remember, high voltage side is having low current and high resistance, and low voltage side is having high current and low resistance. Now next is voltage regulation. Now what is voltage regulation? When the transformer is loaded, when we are loading the transformer, the transformer draws more current, and due to which the primary and secondary side current increases. Now there is an impedance on both the sides, so there is a drop in the secondary side voltage, that is the drop in the V2 across the load. So the percentage regulation is nothing but it is the decrease in the secondary side voltage, which is expressed as a fraction of no load voltage. So percentage regulation is equal to E2 minus V2 upon E2 into 100. Now what is E2? E2 is the no load secondary voltage, and V2 is secondary terminal voltage on given load. Now this regulation is again depends upon the type of load. Now suppose the load is inductive load. All of you know that in inductive load the power factor is lagging. So in inductive load V2 is less than E2, so regulation is positive. In case of capacitive load, the power factor is leading power factor, V2 is greater than E2, hence percentage regulation is negative. So the performance of the transformer is depends upon voltage regulation. So for a good performance of transformer, voltage regulation should be as small as possible. Now next is efficiency. Efficiency is the ratio of output power to input power. Now in case of transformer, when the power is transferring from input to output, the losses are takes place in the transformer. The losses are copper losses and iron losses. So we have to consider that losses while calculating the efficiency of a transformer. So here efficiency is output power upon input power. Now I am expressing this input power in terms of losses. So efficiency is equal to output power upon output power plus losses. Now what is the output power of a transformer? V2 I2 into cos of phi 2. Cos of phi 2 is the power factor upon V2 I2 cos of phi 2 into iron losses plus copper losses into 100. Now in this case V2 I2 is in volt ampere. Suppose if in the numerical KVA rating is given, then we have to convert that KVA rating into volt ampere. So relation is 1000 volt ampere is equal to 1 KV. So the formula becomes KVA into 1000 cos of phi 2 upon KVA into 1000 cos of phi 2 plus PI plus PCU into 100. So this formula is for full load efficiency. That means that efficiency at which the transformer is designed, or it is the rated efficiency. But in the practical case, the transformers are not always the fully loaded. Sometimes it is 25% of the full load, sometimes it is 50%, sometimes no load condition. So in that case, how to calculate the efficiency? So in that case, we have to consider a fractional number, that is x. Now what is x? X is nothing but actual load upon full load. If the load is 50%, then the value of x is equal to 0.5. If the load is 75% of the full load, then the value of x is equal to 0.75. Now the question is, why we are multiplying by x for KVA and copper losses only? Why we are not multiplying with copper iron loss? See, iron loss is a constant loss. Hence, if you changes the load, it will not affect on the iron loss. Hence, the iron loss is as it is. Now consider the volt ampere. Now when the load is changing, the current is changing, and hence we are multiplying by x here. Now what about the copper loss? Copper loss is equal to I square R loss. So current is changing square of the current, hence x square into copper loss at full load. This is the curve between efficiency versus load. So as we increases the efficiency, load efficiency increases, and after overload it starts decreasing. So efficiency also decides the performance of the transformer. Efficiency should be as maximum. It should be the efficiency of the transformer is normally 98 to 99%. Now the next concept is maximum efficiency. Efficiency of a transformer is maximum when copper losses is equal to iron losses. Copper losses are variable losses which is equal to iron loss. That time transformer is having maximum efficiency. Now for maximum efficiency, again the current is maximum, so we have to change the kVA max. According to maximum efficiency condition, variable losses is equal to iron losses. Now the variable losses are copper losses, that is I square R, which is equal to PI. So X is equal to square root of PI upon PC. Therefore kVA corresponds to maximum efficiency, that is kVA max is equal to X into kVA, which is equal to square root of PI upon PCU into kVA. Now I am modifying the formula of efficiency for maximum efficiency. So maximum efficiency is equal to kVA max into 1000 cos of phi upon kVA max into 1000 into cos of phi plus 2pi, because PCU is equal to PI, into 100. And how to calculate kVA max? kVA max is equal to kVA at full load into square root of PI upon PCU. Now suppose if in the numerical kVA rating is not given, only V2 I2 is given, then first we have to calculate I2 max by the formula I2 full load into square root of PI upon PCU, and then put in the formula V2 into I2 max cos of phi upon V2 into I2 max cos of phi plus 2PI into 100. That means there are three conditions for the efficiency. One is the full load condition. In that condition X is equal to 1. Then at any load, that time you have to multiply by X, and this is the maximum efficiency. There are three formulas for maximum efficiency. Now next is direct loading test for finding efficiency and regulation. So efficiency and regulation of transformer operating on any load and power factor can be determined by direct loading test. So this is the experimental setup of direct loading test. We have already conducted this experiment in the lab. So in this case, primary winding at primary side, a watt meter is connected W1, which gives us input power. Then ammeter, which reads current, primary side current, and voltmeter, which reads primary side voltage. Similarly, on the secondary side, ammeter reads secondary side current, wattmeter reads output power, and voltage gives us secondary side voltage. Now while performing the practical, first make sure that the load is off. Then switch on the supply and adjust the VRM, that is the auto transformer, to get rated primary voltage V1. Then observe the reading on no load condition. When all the loads are off, that time I2 equal to 0. We have to note down V1, I1, W1. V2, I2 and W2. Then switch on the load step by step. Switch on the load step by step, 50%, 25%, then 50%, 75%, full load condition and overload condition. That is 125% of the full load. Then after getting all the readings, we have to calculate the efficiency of the transformer by the formula percentage efficiency is equal to W2 upon W1 into 100. What is W2? W2 is the output power or watt meter reading on the secondary side. W1 is input power, that is watt meter reading on the primary side. Similarly, we have to find out voltage regulation. Percentage regulation is equal to E2 minus V2 upon E2 into 100. Now what is E2? E2 is no load secondary voltage and V2 is secondary side voltage at any load. So when the secondary is open circuited, that time I2 equal to 0. So whatever the EMF induced in the secondary side, that will appear on the load open circuited terminals. So hence for the start, when the load is switched off, regulation of the transformer is 0. So this is the direct loading test. Now next is auto transformer. Auto transformer is a special type of transformer such that a part of the winding is common to both primary and secondary. So this is the practical view of auto transformer. We have already used this transformer in the lab while doing so many experiments. So what is the difference in single phase transformer and the auto transformer? In single phase transformer, primary and secondary are on both the limbs, but in auto transformer there is a single winding which is common for both primary as well as secondary. So auto transformer can be used as a step up or step down the transformer. So in this circuit diagram, this auto transformer is as a step down transformer. So XZ is the primary number of turns and YZ is secondary number of turns. So primary number of turns are greater than secondary number of turns, hence it is a step down transformer. In case of step up transformer, in this case YZ is the primary number of turns and XZ is the secondary number of turns. So secondary number of turns are greater than the primary, so it is step up transformer. Now these are the advantages of auto transformer over a single phase transformer. So copper required in case of auto transformer is always less than the two winding transformer, so it is always cheaper. For same rating, weight of the auto transformer is less than the two winding transformer. The copper losses taking place in a transformer are less. Due to less copper loss, efficiency of the transformer is higher than that of the two winding transformer. Auto transformer has better regulation than of the two winding transformer. Now these are the disadvantages. There is always a risk of electric shock as the primary and secondary are not electrically separated. So in case of step down auto transformer, if the common part gets open due to any fault, the high voltage on the primary side will damage the measuring instruments, typically voltmeter connected on the secondary side. Now these are the applications of auto transformer. It can be used as a starter for squirrel cage induction motor. It can be used as a booster to raise the voltage in AC feeders. It can be used in industry as a furnace transformers for getting required voltage, and it can be used as a dimmer for dimming the lights. So here we have completed the theory part of the transformer. Now let us see some numericals. So this is the numerical. A 40 kVA 2200 volt / 220 volt 50 hertz single phase transformer has an iron loss of 250 watt. The resistance of low and high voltage windings are 0.005 ohm and 0.5 ohm respectively. Calculate the efficiency of a transformer at full load and 0.8 power factor lagging. Now the first we have to write the given data. So in the data, 40 kVA, that is the kVA rating is given, then 2200 volt is the primary side voltage and 220 is secondary side voltage. Now the 2200 is the primary side voltage, that which is greater than the secondary, so primary side is high voltage winding. So while writing the resistances, we should know high voltage winding is in this particular numerical is primary voltage. So high voltage winding resistance is 0.5 ohm, that is R1 is equal to 0.5 ohm. Now low voltage winding is secondary winding whose resistance is 0.005 ohm. This is important point. Now we have to find out the efficiency at full load. So for full load condition, X value is 1. Okay, so first what we have to calculate, first the I1 full load and I2 full load. What is the formula for I1 full load? KVA into 1000 divided by V1. So 40 into 1000 divided by V1, that is 2200. Then I2 is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V2, that is 40 into 1000 divided by 220 volt. Okay, so here you can see high voltage, high resistance, low current. Similarly, low voltage, low resistance and high current. Now for finding the copper loss, formula is R1 into I1 square plus R2 into I2 square. So copper loss is 330.53 watt. Now efficiency is equal to, the formula is, here no need to write X because the value of X is equal to 1. So you just write volt ampere into power factor divided by volt ampere into power factor plus PI plus PCU full load. Okay, substitute the values, the answer is 98.21%. This is the efficiency, that is the full load efficiency of a transformer. Now this is another type of numerical. A 25 kVA 50 Hz single phase transformer has the iron loss and full load copper loss of 350 and 400 watt respectively. Find the efficiency of the transformer at 50% of full load at unity power factor and 75% of full load at 0.75 lagging power factor. Now in this case, the efficiency is not the full load efficiency. The efficiency is 50% of the full load and 75% of the full load. That means we have to use the formula which is having X fraction number. Okay, so efficiency is equal to X into volt ampere rating into power factor divided by X into volt ampere rating into power factor plus PI plus X square into full load copper loss. Okay, just substitute the values in the numerical, the answer is 96.52%. You just verify this. Then similarly, the same formula is for 75% of the full load. In this case, the value of X is equal to 0.75. in first case, the power factor is unity, so consider cos phi is equal to 1. But for the second case, the power factor is 0.75. So here we have to take the power factor as 0.75. Now the next problem, that is 15 kVA 2200/110 volt transformer has primary side resistance 1.75 ohm and R2 is equal to 0.0045 ohm. Find out equivalent resistance referred to primary and equivalent resistance referred to secondary. So here KVA rating is given 15 kVA, then V1 is 2200 volt, V2 is 110 volt, R1 is 1.75 ohm. R2 is 0.0045 ohm. Now we have to find out equivalent resistance referred to primary side, that is R1E. So R1E is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. Now what is R2 dash? R2 dash is the secondary side resistance of transformer referred to primary side. So R2 dash is equal to R2 upon K square. Now what is K? K is the transformation ratio, in this case V2 by V1, which is 0.05. Okay, so the answer of R2 dash is 1.8. Substitute in R1E, so the answer is 3.55 ohm. Now for finding R2E, that is equivalent resistance referred to secondary side, R2E is equal to R1 dash plus R2. R1 dash is primary resistance of transformer referred to secondary. So R1 dash is equal to K square into R1. So R2 is 8.875 into 10 raised to minus 3 ohm. You just verify these answers by using the calculators. Now another type of question is again a type of numerical. A direct loading test is to be conducted on single phase 230/110 volt 2 kVA transformer. Write down the ranges of the meters with the reasons. So in this problem, we have to write the meters which is required for performing direct loading test. So meters required are voltmeter and ammeters. So here the given data, V1 is equal to 230 volt, V2 is equal to 110 volt. So voltmeter on the primary side, as the rated primary voltage is 230 volt, on the primary side the range should be 0 to 250 volt. The voltmeter on the secondary side, as the rated secondary voltage is 110 volt, voltmeter on secondary side can be selected on the range 0 to 150 volt. Now for current rating, first we have to calculate the primary side full load current, which is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V1. So the current is 8.695, that means we have to select at least 0 to 10 ampere. For secondary side, again we have to calculate secondary side full load current, that is I2 is equal to KVA into 1000 upon V2, which value is 18.18. So the ammeter on the secondary side can be selected as 0 to 20 ampere. So here I have completed the transformer theory as well as numericals. Now you go through this lectures and solve as many as problems. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you.